We really, really appreciate your feedback on our videos. So here is one of the recent comments which we got on our previous video from one of our subscribers requesting us for a video on how to prepare for reading comprehension. So friends, I'm Sunish from Team Must, and in this video I'm going to discuss about some tips for reading comprehension, what to do and what not to. The most important thing, understand what you read. Being able to read fast is also important, but remember that speed is always secondary to understanding. Don't rush yourself. It's a natural thing. You'll start a little slow and then build up the speed as you gain familiarity with the passage. Read some questions first. Whenever you are given a passage to read, always read the questions first. The basic ones which give you an idea of what you are expected to extract from the passage. By doing this, you are well aware of that what to look for into the passage and when you are reading this passage. This helps you focus your attention on important words and phrases rather than having to read each and every word. Also, you can mark the passage lightly when you see one of those terms, making it easy to find when you are ready to verify your answers. Get the overview. After you have read the passage, ask yourself the following questions. What is the passage as a whole trying to say? What is the motive of the passage? What does each paragraph contribute to the broad message of the passage? For vocab questions, refer to the paragraph. Some questions will ask you about a specific word from a paragraph. Keep in mind that you are not expected to tell the definition of this word, and most of the time the standard dictionary definition will be the listed one among the answer choices and will be incorrect. Mark my words, it would be incorrect. Look back to the passage and ask yourself, how is this word being used in the context? Try to come up with your own word that is similar in meaning and could replace the word in the sentence. Looking for the main idea? Refer first and last paragraph. Focus on the first and final paragraphs to find the main idea. Usually, the first para is used to introduce a topic and start discussion of main idea. The final paragraph wraps up the discussion of the body paragraphs and reinforces the main idea. If you are having a trouble finding the overall purpose of the theme of the passage, use these two paragraphs. Stop and analyze. Train yourself to stop periodically and analyze as to what the author wants to indicate by the usage of particular phrases. Make sure you focus on the main points of the passage and understand the main theme of the passage. Cultivate a regular habit of reading. This is the most important thing which I feel. Regular reading improves not just your reading speed but also the depth of your understanding of an unfamiliar passage. So cultivate a regular reading habit. Now let's discuss about some things which should not be done, which we should not do while doing all those questions in reading comprehensions. So, do not overemphasize trivial details. Details are important, but do not obsess yourself with examples, illustrations and so on. You need to understand the main point, not the examples. Second thing, you do not need to memorize every word in the passage. Understand the flow and the main points in the passage and you're good to go. For factual specific point questions, you can always return to the passage. It's with you. Third thing, do not overemphasize on vocabulary skills for RCs. Having a strong vocabulary is great. I should say that's appreciable, but remember, being average in area doesn't prevent you from understanding the passage. So while reading the passage, make sure you try to understand the gist of the passage and not to get stuck on particular words. Do not spend time on RCs that you cannot comprehend at first. At times we discover a passage which we are simply not able to read. If you are struggling with one such passage in the exam, make sure you first finish the ones that you can manage easily. Go back to the tricky passage only if you are done with the other questions, else avoid these. I must say really avoid these. These are the time killers that spoils your overall attempt in the exam. Do not bring in outside knowledge. You are not required to have the outside knowledge for the reading comprehension passage. If the paragraph says you are a dog, Assume that you are a dog. Your own biases might actually hurt you when answering the questions, especially if it's an opinion passage. So this was all about the comprehension, folks. Please like the video if you found it really helpful, and make sure you subscribe to our channel Teamers, as a lot more videos coming on. Till then, be must and keep rocking. And yes, all the very best for your exams. That's it.